阿利亚啊，奉主受圣名，我们继续昨天的课程。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we continue yesterday's class.
那我们昨天讲到1.7。
Yesterday we got to point 1.7.
那在开始讲之前呢，有两个问题。
And before I begin the class, there are two questions.
这个是早祷问题啊，昨天的早祷。
From yesterday morning's prayer, one of them is from the prayer.
那第一个问题啊，你们有吗？你们有看见吗？
对的。
问题是说，有一些信徒他们他们这样相信，some members believe，相信什么呢？只有就是传道能够在讲台上来传讲，就是讲道，就是。Some members believe that only pastors can deliver the sermon on the pulpit. 然后呢others, 括号哈 deacons, brothers and sisters shouldn't, 也就是说其他的像执事啦弟兄姐妹都不行。How do you explain this? 你怎么来解释？这些弟兄这些信徒他们为什么这样相信我就不知道了。
I'm not sure why these members may believe this.
我目前我自己是好像没有遇到。
And I have not met these people who believe this personally.
但是这个问题那个包含很多的方向。
But this question has many aspects to it.
如果从这个题目来看的话，
So if we look at this question,
我们先来看谁 can 就是能够，这是 can 的话就是表示能力了，能够在讲台上来讲道。
So it says only pastors can, meaning that pastors have
to only pastors. 那我们是先来讲说谁能够。
So, let's talk about who is able to.
就是 who can. 其实用很平常的心来想的话。
And so, generally speaking,
你受洗了，归入耶稣基督了。
After you have been baptized and enter into the fold,
领受恩典啊,
you have received grace.
好，基本上你就可以开始来述说耶稣给你的爱，你的见证。
Then you can start to proclaim the testimony and the grace that God has given to you.
如果你接下来你得到应许的圣灵了。
And after you receive the promised Holy Spirit,
今天我们会讲到那里的，就是你会得到能力。
Then, as we will mention today, you will receive strength or power.
不管你愿意不愿意，你有那个传福音、见证耶稣的这个责任。
Whether you are willing or not, you have the responsibility to preach the gospel.
好，那在这个题目里面呢，他又其实包含了很多的限制或者那个范围了。
This question also encompasses a lot of boundaries.
第一个就是那个 pulpit 就是讲台。
First of all, there's the pulpit.
那讲台一般都是如果只是一个讲台，然后呢没有聚会，你一个人站在那里讲，那应该是不是这样？所谓的在讲台，就是说在一个集体的有教会聚会的一个场所。
So delivering a sermon on the pulpit probably is inferring to speaking to the congregation.
那接下来你又设定一个sermon，sermon就是一定不是讲心得啦、感想啦、讲生活的杂事。
And then there's the boundary of sermon in this question, which means that you're not talking about your reflections on life.
也不是及时的说，哦，我忽然有一个念头。
Or that you have a sudden inspiration to speak.
好，那并且呢是 deliver the sermon， 那就很正式了。So
delivering a sermon is very formal.
以这个题目来讲。So
based on this question.
我认为如果一个受洗的信徒。
I believe that if a member is baptized.
并且得到圣灵了。And
he has also received the Holy Spirit.
那他也能够，也就是说，他有准备，并且他也有能力了。你这样，哎。And
if he has already prepared and has the ability.
如果你叫一个五岁的，从小洗礼又得圣灵的小孩来讲道，除非他是很特别的，不然。
So, for example, if you have a five-year-old who has already received the Holy Spirit and is baptized, he's still not, unless there's a special circumstance, he is not fit to give a sermon.
所以这个问题是，我只是认为，只要刚刚我讲过的这个条件，并且他还能够，他就可以来讲道。
So as long as this person fulfills these criteria and he's able to, then he can deliver the sermon.
姐妹可以，弟兄可以。So
for brothers and for sisters.
那个传道也是弟兄，那个执事也是弟兄，或是姐妹。传道执事都是弟兄姐妹了。
Pastors and deacons are brothers and sisters as well.
好，所以我的回答是这样子。So
this is my answer.
好，那第二个问题哈。Second
question.
如何辨别败子？
How do we discern the tares?
那我们如果看马太福音十三章。Let's
if we look at Matthew chapter 13.
那这个。 败子是那个敌人，就是耶稣的敌人，就撒旦，撒的。There
is the enemy of Jesus Christ, who is Satan.
这个败子最跟那个好种子，这是相对等的一个词。And
this, there are two concepts that are contrasting each other, which is a contrast to the seed.
Is
the tear.
Okay. 那个好种就是那个撒的是种子, huh?
So
就是麦的种子。
The good seed is the seed of the wheat.
然后从这个种子当然之后人接受长出来的就是这个人是
Now the people are the grown wheat.
好，那跟这个一样，稗子它最原始的也是稻米哈。The
tares also in its original form is our teachings.
哎，当然这就是魔鬼的道理。
Of course, this refers to the teachings of Satan.
那魔鬼道理当然最主要是破坏得救的真道。
And the teachings of Satan are targeted toward destroying the truth.
好，那怎么辨别败子？
How can you discern the tares?
败子就是跟得救要道不合的都是败子。
Everything that is contrary to the gospel of salvation is the tare.
也就是保罗所讲的那个纯正的福音的规模。
This is the pattern of sound words that Paul talked about.
好，那我们一般人认为稗子是人哈，稗子最原始的是道理啊。
We often assume that these tares are people, but in its original form, it is actually a teaching.
所以那个这个稗子什么时候开始在教会里面？
When the tares start to occur in the church?
在使徒时代就存在了。
They already appeared during the apostolic time.
也就是说，主耶稣离世之后，那使徒们出去传福音，然后他们没有想到就是没有什么警醒的时候，这个稗子就来了。圣经是说他们睡觉的时候。
So after the Lord Jesus ascended, they started to preach the gospel, and just like it says that while men slept, so they weren't aware, but the tares started to come.
他们一看，哎，长出来了。这个稗子的种啊，就长出来了，就成为土那个什么，土长苗吐穗的时候，这是一个阶段了哈。
Then they saw that the tares had already sprouted. There was a certain time that this happened.
那使徒们就说要拔。
Therefore, the apostles said we need to pull them out.
主耶稣说不用拔。
But the Lord Jesus said, do not tear them out.
所以要留到现在，留了一千多年了。
You need to be kept there, and they've been there for more than 1,000 years.
那因为是在世界末了的现在才要拔稗子。
It is during the end times that the tares must be taken out.
所以这个稗子从使徒时代就一直流经过了各个教会，就是这当中已经是堕落的或是变质的教会，一直到耶稣教会出来才会拔出来。
These tares or false teachings have continued on throughout history so that we see different denominations of churches all the way until now where we see the appearance of the true Jesus church.
So, 如果你看13章的30节,
Let's look at chapter 13, verse 30.
世界末了的时候，收割的人要先将稗子薅出来，捆成捆，留着要烧。
At the end times, they will gather together the tares and bind them in bundles to burn them.
所以耶稣教会一出来哈，
So at the appearance,
他就先捆这个稗子了。
At the appearance of the true Jesus Church, these tares were gathered and bound together.
不是绑人哦。
Not people.
这个是就是从历史存留下来的这个异端呐、啊，就是。
But these are the heresies that have continued on until now.
那当然，我们耶稣教会一出来就。那个得救的真理显明啊。
When the true Jesus Church appeared, then the truth also was revealed.
以我们现在来讲，就是五大教义了。
So this refers to the ten basic beliefs. 五大教义。
我们用很具体的讲哈，我们正是要一开始这个跟得救直接有关系的这个五项重要的道理，一直到现在都不变的。
These five most important aspects to salvation should not and will not change.
那以我们现在来讲，就是十大信条哈。我如果讲更宽一点的话
，So more broadly speaking, it refers to the Ten Articles of Faith.
那其实我们的十大信条是对基督教界其他的教会的一个捆绑，就是他们的错误的道理的捆绑。
These articles of faith are just like binding up the false teachings, the misconceptions of the other churches.
这是最基础的，什么叫做败子啊？
This is the most basic understanding of a tear.
那在保罗那个时代，没有人家不会把它当成败子的。
During the apostolic time, people did not refer to, see this as a tear.
人家只是把它当不认为它是那个有使徒位份啊，对他当时来讲是不把它当成使徒位份的人，其实不是外面的不信的人，而是当时的那个教会。
At that time, they just deemed these people as those who did not hold the position of apostle.
好，那我们怎么会知道这个人之后会变成败子呢？啊，变成麦子呢？我们知道这人之后变成麦子呢？
The question.
这人是保罗吗？还是任何一个人？
The question also asks, was not Paul also what the disciples at the time would consider a tear? How do we know that this person would become wheat?
我讲那个败子最根本的就是道理问题。
The fundamental problem of the tear is the teachings.
就是得救的道理问题。
The teachings regarding salvation.
从魔鬼来的。这个变质的东西
，and these tears are teachings that have deviated from the truth from the devil.
我们来看一节啊，启示录在启示录的时候已经有这样的一个现象。
In the book of Revelation, we can see this phenomenon.
我怕越讲哦，你那如果问题越多哦，这个属性上讲不完。但是这个不是我的主题啊，没有关系了，来。那我们看那个启示录第二章。
Let's look at Revelation chapter 2.
在使徒时代有三个很大的，就是那个败子。
During the apostolic time, there were three major tares.
败种，败子的种子。
The seed of the tares.
第一个就是巴兰的。教训。
First is the teaching of Balaam.
第二个就是尼哥拉的教训。
Secondly, the teachings of the Nicolaitans.
第三个就是耶洗别的教训。
Thirdly, the teachings of Jezebel.
好，我们看第二十四节。
Let's look at verse 24.
推拉，其余的人就是一切不从那教训，不晓得他们素常所说。撒旦深奥之理的，所以在当时耶洗别的传讲的就是撒旦深奥之理呀。
This verse tells us that at the time Jezebel, the teachings of Jezebel, are the doctrines of Satan.
那他们所表，这个是道理哦。
These are doctrines.
这个道理就是那个种在或是撒在当时的教会里面的。
These doctrines had been sown in the church.
也就是魔鬼撒在耶稣的田里的。
Satan had sown these in the field of Jesus Christ.
我们在那个马太福音13章哈。耶稣先撒好种在他的田里。
In Matthew chapter 13, this man, the Lord Jesus, had sown seed in his field.
然后敌人来了。
The enemy came.
他也在上面，然后呢，在 他掺杂在里面，又撒他的败子，就是撒旦深奥之理呀、啊。
And this enemy came to sow tares among the wheat, which are his doctrines.
那使徒时代到最后，若看历史的话，就是被这些道理给淹没了。
Throughout the history of the apostolic church, we see how the church was overwhelmed by these false teachings.
但是在地下面那个就是麦子的那个根还在。
However, underground, the root of the wheat still existed.
那这个根就是。以使徒是那来讲的话，最后的总结就是新约圣经。
And this refers to the New Testament.
那所以到我们真耶稣教会出来了。
When the True Jesus Church appeared.
那神就赐下应许的圣灵。
Then the Lord Jesus Christ sent down His Holy Spirit.
那首先就把这些历史以来的巴兰教训、尼哥拉教训，还有那个这些全部就是清除了，真耶稣教会就是建立了。
Then the Lord Jesus cleared out all of these false teachings, the teachings of Jezebel, of Balaam, the Nicolaitans, and then the True Jesus Church was established.
那真耶稣教会在100多年的历史里面
，through the 100 years of the history of the TJC,
也有几次魔鬼也在教会里面撒败子。
Satan also used a few opportunities to sow tares.
这个败子最主要是败坏教会根基的道理。
These tares are doctrines that corrupt the foundations of the church.
如果你看那个我们的圣灵报哈，1950年的哈。
If we refer to the 1950 edition of the Holy Spirit Monthly.
那个时候有一个总会哈，总会的教务哈，总会的总那个负责人，常务负责里面的教务叫做蒋约翰。
And there was a worker in the assembly which is called John Jing.
他写的文章哈。他的笔名叫做那个姑苏吴无，就是姑苏寒山寺那个姑苏，无就是没有，无就是我，没有我的那个，他可能是江苏人吧，我不知道。
And so he had a pen name.
他写什么
？What did he write？
他写的就是在当时，就是说魔鬼是那个。自由不拥有，就是自存不永存呐。
He wrote an article saying that, Satan is, self-existing but not existing always.
那这个就引起山西，你看那个圣灵月刊哦，山西有一些教会，他们就在大会里面，就是，当时全国，大会开会提出来要讨论。
Because of this, some churches in Sanxi, brought this up at a national conference.
但是呢，这个很奇妙的。
It was very miraculous.
事情发生了。
What happened?
那个，后来这件事情呢，就有那个郭子炎长老哈，他写了那个。真道问答提要。
There was an elder, Elder Guo, who wrote a question and answer book.
他这本书特别哈，对这个魔鬼这个来源这个特别有做问答。
He especially answered the question regarding Satan.
那其实当时的那个蒋约翰是很有，如果以属事来讲很有名望的，他是总会的那个那个常务副责啊，五个常务副责之一啊的那个应该是教务啊。
Physically speaking, Elder John Jing was someone of authority because he was one of the five representatives of the assembly.
那当我们知道接下来之后，那个大陆的教会就休息了，
We know that after that, the churches in China
就比较停顿一点了哈，应该是这样。
started to stagnate a little bit.
那到差不多2000年左右，
Around 2000.
这样就经过50年了。
This
那
was
在真
50
耶稣
years
教会里
later.
面，在联总又开始在这个问题又提被在当时的工人提出来。那他所讲的跟你可以比较一下，他所讲的跟50年前差不多。
This was 50 years later, but in 2000, one of the workers in the IA also brought up the same thing.
论点差不多哈。
His
你可以比较一下。
points were pretty similar. You can compare it.
那像这种，这个它的力道很强哦，
He was very convincing.
因为这是从魔鬼来的，魔鬼深奥的道理。
Because this is the doctrine of Satan.
但是呢，跟属时代不一样了。
But it is different from that in the apostolic time.
第一次魔鬼把这深奥的道理放在真耶稣教会里面的那个总会的，这全国总会的负责那常务负责人的身上，但是马上被捆绑了，没有发起来。
The first time that this tare was planted in this this
当
assembly
时还没有，
representative，
当时只有。就是对，就是在中国全国会议了。
China in the assembly over there, when this tare was first planted, it was immediately bundled up.
那20世纪这一次呢，也是一样。
The same occurred in the 20th century.
但是。当然，在这个事件的发生当中，有一些人如果被魔鬼迷惑的，也就会跟着走。
Of course, if there are those who are already deceived by Satan, then they will also follow.
所以，以种子来讲，这个败子的种子，在以现在我们末世来讲，不会像使徒时代一样，就是把整个教会淹没掉，不用怕。
So we do not need to fear that the same thing will happen to our church in the end times, that the tares will overwhelm the wheat. This will not happen.
那等一下，我们会继续看到，我们每个人同工了，我们都是要自己要谨慎的，因为魔鬼会在你的身上下功夫。
Later, we will study how all of us as workers need to be careful because Satan will try to work in us.
像这种不是人事的哦，不要把它混到人事里面来讲。其实这是灵界的，那个是。拜子的问题是道理的问题，哈。
These are all matters regarding the spiritual realm, so let us not confuse it with physical matters.
因为如果你认为魔鬼自存，其实是亵渎神的。
If you believe that Satan is self-existing, this is blaspheming God.
无论谁都一样，无论你是长老、传道、执事、弟兄、姐妹。你直接是在亵渎神，你跟别人没有什么关系的。
This is a direct blasphemy against God, regardless of if you are a brother, sister, deacon, or an elder, or a pastor.
那去那个至于个别的个人哦，你如果相信了 魔鬼种在你心里的败子，那你发出来了，那你这个人当然就是败子了哈。
Personally speaking, if you believe the seed, the tare that is planted in your heart and you allow for it to grow, then you will become a tare.
那这里说我们当如何对待败子？
Now the question is, how should we treat the tares?
以我刚刚讲的败子哈，败子不是我们一般人所想的说他这个人品性不好啦，或是他是赌博啦，或是酗酒啦，或是在教会里面骗钱啦。
The tares are not those who, how we commonly might think of them as people who have poor character or who gamble, etc.
这个是他个人行为的一个差错，或是那个被过患所胜哈。
These would simply just be categorized as those who are overcome by sin.
不是那个耶稣在马太福音十三章那个所讲的那个败子。
These are not the tares that the Lord Jesus speaks of in Matthew 13.
你看那个耶稣所讲的那个败子是使徒时代的败子，然后呢，一千年多之后才捆绑，那不是讲人啊，若人的话，这个人一千多岁了。
The tares that the Lord Jesus refers to are the seeds, that were planted during the apostolic time and were bundled up 1,000 years later. This could not refer to humans.
好，那会不会解释太久了哈？来，我们。奉主耶稣圣名，我们继续来看，稍微提一下昨天的哈，我们是讲到辫子的使徒。
So in the name of Jesus Christ, we continue our class. Yesterday we talked about, deteriorated apostles.
假使徒。
The false apostles.
假使徒不是一时的，在使徒时代不是一时的事情。
False apostles were not just a one-time thing.
假使徒在什么时候出现?
When did the false apostles appear?
就是那个保罗设立了哥林多教会之后，在哥林多教会就出现了。
After Paul established the Corinthian church, there were false apostles there.
今天我们要讲的就是第二部分哈。
Today we will talk about the second section.
大家应该有这个应该有这个讲义了哈。
Everyone should have the handout.
那这个哥林多教会是保罗所建立的。
The church in Corinth was established by Paul.
是在以我的讲义来讲的话，就是那个第三阶段直到第几的第二次的宣道。
This is established during the third progression of the gospel, which is preaching the gospel to the ends of the earth.
应该他在那个时候是主后这个年代哈，我要先声明一下，这个年代差有时候差一两年、两三年都没有关系的，因为这个是没有办法去拿准的，这个理论也太多了。
So whenever we see the different dates, sometimes they can be off by 2 or 3 years, but this is not a big deal.
那哥林多教会差不多在主后50年到52年当中设立的。
The Corinthian church was established around 50 to 52 AD.
好，那离主耶稣的时候，就是离那个耶路撒冷开始建立教会，差不多21、22年就那个。假使徒就多到怎么讲？多到排除不了，排除不了了。
This was about 20 some years after the establishment of the church in Jerusalem. By this time, the false apostles or false teachers were so many that they could not get rid of them all.
这个使徒时代一开始,
At the beginning of the apostolic church,
就是有12个使徒,
there were 12 apostles.
只有这12个使徒,
and there were only these 12 apostles.
他们是完全的,
they were perfect.
好,
and they started to preach.
那接下来就有第二批的使徒出来。
After that, there was a second wave of apostles.
那接下来呢，就假使徒出来。
After that, there were false apostles.
那从圣从新约可以看得到的是，二十几年之后，从五旬节哦，二十几年之后，假使徒就多到满街跑了，不能说满街了，满教会跑了。
20 some years after the day of Pentecost, there were so many false apostles that they were permeating the church.
好，那1.7.2这个昨天也讲过了哈。
Yesterday we talked about 1.7.2.
你看保罗身上那根刺啊，拔都拔不掉。
The thorn in Paul's body could not be removed.
最大的祈求三次求了。He
had prayed to the Lord 3 times.
但是主耶稣说留着吧。But
the Lord Jesus said, keep it.
好，那我们看启示录第二章第二节。Let's
look at Revelation chapter 2 verse 2.
这个时候已经主后96年了。
By this time, it was 96 AD.
也就是说使徒时代要结束了。This
was near the end of the apostolic time.
我们如果想起来，我们现在我们耶稣教会比那个使徒后期，我们现在幸福多了，或是说门徒多了。Compared
to the end of the apostolic era, we right now are much more blessed.
那我们这个教会实在是干净多了，比他们当时哦干净多了，并且强多了。Our
church is much cleaner and also much stronger.
这都是神的旨意了，都是神的工作。This
is all the will and the work of God.
你看使徒末期，那个启示录2章2节啊。In
Revelation chapter 2 verse 2.
写给以弗所教会。
He was writing to the church in Ephesus.
以弗所教会被主耶稣称赞什么事呢?
What did the Lord Jesus praise Ephesus for?
其中之一就是说，你也曾试验那自称为使徒却不是使徒的，看出他们是假的来。He
praised them because they tested those who say they are apostles and are not.
使徒本来是道同、灵同，并且呢一体的。 提同的一个，就是带领者啊，就是他们身上是带着这三个统序的。The
apostles were supposed to be successors of the truth, the spirit, and the one body.
但是现在这个使徒变成人家要去试验，哎，看对不对？But
now these apostles had to be tested to know whether or not they were true.
现在。 我还没有遇到到一个教会或到一个地方，人家说传道，先来试试看你是不是真的还是假的，哇，就是很悲哀的吧。I
have never had to come across having to go to a church and then being tested whether or not I am a true pastor or not. This would be very pitiful.
约翰福音那个时代也是很悲惨的，你得圣灵了，要试试看这个灵是对不对啊。
During the time of John, when someone received a spirit, they had to test whether the spirit was the right spirit.
要试验.
They had to test.
一试啊，假的.
And when they were tested, they were found to be false.
也就是说，到了主后90几年，那个假使徒啊，满教会啊。
by 90 some AD, there were so many false apostles in the church.
好，那我们现在继续来看那个1.8使徒的职分。
Let's look at 1.8, the affairs of an apostle.
使徒本身是一个职分。
Apostle is a position.
不是 position, 是一个 apostleship.
Apostleship.
是一个 office 啊。
Office.
这个 YLT 这里也讲哈 ，apostleship, NASB 也是这样哈。然后讲义里面，你看它的翻译里面就是一个 apostleship， 啊，罗马书1:5一样嘛哈，也是 apostleship， 啊，那这是所谓的职分。
An apostleship is an office.
但是呢，接下来。那个使徒他也有他的职责，职责就不是职分哈。
Apostles also have their responsibilities, which is
我的讲义有哈，我是就是 duties 哈。
Their duties. Okay.
对，好，那就是你要做的事了。
So the things that they need to do.
要传道了哈。
They need to preach.
要教导。
They need to teach.
再来治理教会。
They need to manage the church.
然后他们是建立教会的根基。
They are also the foundation of the church.
然后呢，使徒的证据是什么？
What is the evidence of an apostle?
就是你有这个职分。有了职分之后。
Which is that after you have this apostleship,
然后接下来你才显出用神迹奇事异能显出你当有这个职分的一个凭据。
You have signs and miracles that accompany you to prove that you are an apostle.
好，最后结论。
And conclusion.
主耶稣选了12个使徒。
The Lord Jesus personally selected the 12 apostles.
那从启示录来看，他们是在神的国里面是十二个柱子。
And they were the 12 pillars of the kingdom of God in the New Testament.
这是要见证主耶稣复活的大信息的最基础的这人员。
They were the fundamental characters that continued to proclaim.And witness for the resurrection of the Lord Jesus.
那接下来呢？那个也要见证，要宣道，也要产生其他的后进的使徒。
While they were preaching and proclaiming the gospel, there were other apostles that were also added.
就我们有昨天讲过了，像那个巴拉巴，他就是。
And as we had mentioned yesterday, we have Barnabas, who is a representative of these other apostles.
那后来接下来，就有众很多的使徒。
After that, there were many apostles.
但是有的呢，就变成假使徒了。
But some of them became false apostles.
这个假使徒一直越来越严重，到启示录的时代，那已经是不能收拾了。
They became worse and worse, so that by the end of the apostolic era, they were out of control.
所以，使徒时代给我们一个很大的教训。
The apostolic era gives us many teachings.
使徒。十二使徒了，使徒兴起教会，开始教会。
The 12 apostles started and revived the church.
假使徒，另外一个就是假先知了。我们这次没有讲哈，假使徒、假先知啊，把整个使徒时代给淹没掉了。
The false apostles and the false prophets, which we did not have time to talk about, overwhelmed the church.
但是你不要用这个来讲真耶稣教会。
But we cannot apply this to the true Jesus Church.
你不要自作聪明，以为说使徒时代会这样子，那真耶稣教会也可能会这样子。
We should not think that since the Apostolic Church went through this, then the True Jesus Church will have the same end.
我跟你们借三分钟，等一下一定还你们哈。 那个反正休息15分钟嘛，一定休息15分钟。不然我这一句话没有讲完，等一下要重开始了。好，<笑>你不要自作聪明说哦，你看使徒时代那个圣灵开始工作很活泼，那后来你看那些有使徒有先知，他们都。
So when we look at the history of the Apostolic Church, we see how it was very prosperous at the beginning, but at the end, it was degenerated.
好，那所以呢，你就说我们真耶稣教会也要小心。
Then we try to apply that saying that the True Jesus Church also needs to be careful.
不然会走上使徒时代的那个命运。
Otherwise, you may encounter the same fate.
这样的看法是错的。
This perspective is wrong.
你对圣经的整个神的那个经纶是没有去思考过的。
You have not thoroughly thought about the plan of God.
错在哪里？
And why is it wrong?
我讲一个对的哈。
I'll tell you something that is right.
使徒时代的有圣灵的工作。
And during the apostolic time, there was the work of the Holy Spirit.
神迹奇事显明。
There were signs and miracles.
当时的工人也蛮有能力。
And the workers at that time were filled with power.
譬如说，迪马也跟保罗一起出去宣道。
For example, Demas also went out with Paul.
但是到最后，他就贪爱世界，就走了。But
in the end, because he lusted after the world, he left.
所以，真耶稣教会的长老、传道、执事、弟兄姐妹们。
Therefore, all of the pastors, elders, deacons, brothers and sisters.
要以这个为鉴戒。Need
to use this as a warning.
可能你信的时候蛮有能力，你蛮有恩典。And
perhaps at the beginning, you when you first believed, you were filled with power and grace.
你为神工作的时候，可能一开始也有神同在的明证。At
the beginning of your ministry, perhaps you also had the evidence of the power of God working with you.
所以。 也要小心，战兢的那个什么，做成得救的功夫。Therefore,
we must work out our own salvation with fear and trembling.
不然你会堕落。Otherwise,
we also will degrade.
这就是个人的。So
this is individual.
好，那以教会来讲的话。
However, from the perspective of the church,
不是真耶稣教会会堕落,
it is not the true Jesus church that will fall apart.
使徒教会最后是隐藏了,堕落了。Although
the apostolic church had fallen apart,
这个不是你我的事情。
It is not a matter concerning you and I.
真耶稣教会一定会到世界末了，这个也不是你我的事情，也就是说，不是你我来决定了，这是神的旨意啊。The
fact that the True Jesus Church will last until the end of the age is also not determined by you and I.
所以我们有赞美诗嘛，真教会必然兴起，这是什么？ 这是神的旨意啊。We
have a hymn in the hymn book that says a true church is established by the will of God.
这个分成两个阶段，从启示录到从那个使徒行传跟启示录可以看得出来的神的救赎的计划。We
can see that the Lord Jesus, God has a plan of salvation, and it has two periods. We can see this both in the book of Acts and in Revelation.
So, 不能喊衰, 不能替真耶稣教会喊衰, 你替真耶稣教会喊衰, 衰弱了, 台湾话说话衰, 你会衰的。
We should not say or call that say that True Jesus Church is defeated on behalf of the church.
真耶稣教会的里面的人, 无论是工人, 从长老, 传道执事, 弟兄姐妹, 他们可能会堕落的, 但是真耶稣教会以整体来讲, 是耶稣的身体, 你把耶稣的身体喊衰, 你不衰, 那个, 还会怎么样呢?
So our downfall will be individual if we do fall, but as a whole, the body of Christ will not fall. If we have that concept, then we will fall.
好，那我们现在默祷休息15分钟。
We will now pray in silence and take a break for 15 minutes.